following the display, which we should put up on the big screen.
SPS cycle, CNGS1. SPS cycle, CNGS1.
Not these guys, no.
No.
SPS
5.
SPS start super cycle.
Next shot is going where?
The first information is here. This is the data taken.
We have examined the direct mass spectrum with the full data sample collected so far. Vertex is here, nice energy deposition in the calorimeter.
The new machine that particle physics community want to build is an E+, E- collider, which will be, you know, some kind of 50 kilometer long. So it's a machine, a very spectacular machine. And it will enable to really study in every detail the new particles that will have been discovered at the LHC. Yes, this machine is very expensive. It will cost something like 10 billion euros or dollars. So, of course, it's a long planning exercise. We think that we will be ready, first on the physics point of view, in 2015, 2016, when the LHC will have given us, for instance, the mass of the Higgs boson. This is a critical parameter to tune up this new machine. And then it will take, you know, a few years to get the governments agreed to build this machine. The machine itself can be built in 7 years. And so we hope to have it online around 2025.
This first data demonstrate that the performance of the detector and the quality of the reconstruction and simulations and results will become more and more rich with missing it in distribution in soft physics and hard.
As for intensity frontier, there are two projects are proposed.
Four months ago. It's only 4 months ago that we started the first collisions with this machine at high energies at 7 TeV center of mass energy. It's the machine is, so to speak, 4 months old. During that time, it has increased the collision rate between the particles. This is what counts for the experiments. It has increased this collision rate by more than a factor of 1,000.
Kamioka, inline experiment for future accelerators. So as for high energy frontier, super LHC, this is the